Good morning. Please be seated. Before we begin this morning's ceremony, I would like to invite Uncle Frank, Wangitja, Wanganeen, Kaurna and Nungana Elder to deliver the welcome to country.
Yeah, thank you. It's a real pleasure to be here today. Doing a welcome to country and being amongst all your students that's receiving their awards. So I just congratulate you. Now I just do the welcome in the country in the Kaurna language. Ngāi tāmpati tuwila, breki āna, ngāi tāmpati bamba vayarendi, Kaurna yurti āna, māori te younger Kaurna miuna, ngāi wangati māni ngāi budni, Kaurna yurti āna, tānda nyanga watli āna. So what I just said is that I just want to acknowledge the ancestors and also recognise where we hold in this event. It's on Kaurna country. And on behalf of the Kaurna people, I want to welcome you all to Tarndanyanga, the place of the red kangaroo. So Nataya, thank you.
Thank you, Uncle Frank. Professor Alan Evans, Provost and Chief Academic Officer, Senior Management and Staff of the University, graduates, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. My name is Pauline Carr. As Chancellor of the University, I'm delighted to welcome you to this graduation ceremony. At the outset, I acknowledge that this ceremony is taking place on Kaurna land. The Kaurna land have performed ceremonies on this land for many centuries, and we pay respect to their living culture and the unique role they continue to play in the life of the Adelaide region. Let me be the first to officially congratulate you on being here today and on getting your degree, and for overcoming all the obstacles that life has thrust at you to receive it here on this day and in this place. You have worked long and hard to get to this point, and while I know that you cannot wait to start your celebrations, I'm here to tell you that the hard work has really only just begun. Once today's celebrations are over, you'll be faced with a future like few others before you. It is a future with many unknowns, but I'm happy to say amongst those unknowns are some extraordinary possibilities. We're all facing challenges and uncertainties, no matter what field your expertise lies in. You will be asked to step up and contribute your talent, your education, and your commitment to whatever career you have chosen. The current health crisis has created many challenges, but if anybody can navigate through those challenges in their working life, you can. If ever there was a cohort who could turn challenges into opportunities, it's you. You have proven to be adaptive, responsive, and flexible. And if you've chosen a career that you're passionate about, truly amazing things will happen, because you'll find that hard work isn't really hard work at all. And as educated, competitive, spontaneous, adventurous, and curious people, more than any other generations that came before, you are perfectly positioned for this time. The past year has taught us many lessons, but it has given us all a renewed sense of community and an opportunity to display kindness and compassion and sensitivity we are all capable of. You have been given the skills and knowledge to succeed in whatever career you've chosen to follow, and I wish you well in your future endeavours. Many of you have already demonstrated how strong and resilient and open to possibilities you are as you quickly and easily moved your studies and your work online in the face of a public health emergency. That's the very sort of resilience that employers look for. proof that you can and will adapt to changing circumstances. Proof that learning is so important that you'll continue to learn under any circumstances. Proof that your attitude and work ethic gives you the freedom to work independently. And proof that you'll let nothing stand in the way of achieving what you set out to achieve. I would add that the soft skills that you bring to your new career environment will make all the difference. How we deal with challenges, how we support others to deal with challenges, makes us who we are. You have a duty to look out for your colleagues and treat them well, because that is what people will remember about you. Whatever degree you have studied, whatever career you are planning, however keen you are to start in a new phase of your life, please take a moment today to look back and congratulate yourself on a job well done. All those late nights, long hours and endless Zoom meetings were very much worth it. All of us here today, all the university people who have worked with you during your studies, share your pride and joy. In building your knowledge and skills, it is our goal as a university to equip our graduates to make a real and enduring contribution to society. I'm certain that one of the keys to your success has been the love, support and encouragement of those closest to you, your family and your friends. I'm sure you're all aware, as am I, that without that support you would not be here today. And to demonstrate your appreciation and to thank your family and friends for their invaluable contribution, I ask that you stand up, face your loved ones and give them a big clap and cheer. Thank you, graduates. It is now my pleasure to ask our Provost and Chief Academic Officer, Professor Alan Evans, to address you.
Thank you, Chancellor. Good morning, everybody. Let me begin by expressing my congratulations on your academic achievement. It makes the entire university community very happy to see you all robed and ready to graduate. And graduation, as the Chancellor said, is one of those special events in life, not just for you, but for your family and friends who have supported you through your studies. And despite the multiple disruptions over the past 12 months, we know how important graduation is. We know how important it is that you have the opportunity to officially graduate in front of your family and friends who have supported you, whether they be here today or watching online through our streaming service. As a parent of three UniSA graduates myself, I know precisely how proud they are of your achievements. So on this day, arguably one of the landmark occasions of your life journey, I want you to pause for a moment and give thought to the success and the success of your colleagues around you as you all embark on those journeys as yet uncharted. You have put some hard work in over the past few years as you've confronted a myriad of annoying assignments, essays, tests, vivas and exams, and of course the assessment items you like the most, beloved group assignments. And being here today, thankfully, means that you passed many more times than you failed. And that's precisely what success looks like. Don't expect to succeed every time you try something. Learn from those times where it doesn't quite work out. Your UniSA education has given you more than just knowledge. It gives you a solid basis on which to build your career, and it shows the values of professionalism, scholarship, engagement, social justice, innovation, and openness. If you apply these attributes in equal measure throughout your life, personal success is inevitable. Now, while it's usual at such events for speakers to quote poets, authors, and influential leaders, I always lean on the words of those who have inspired me the most, the scientists who changed the world. And aptly, one of my scientific heroes was the French chemist, biologist, and microbiologist, Louis Pasteur, who said, "Knowledge belongs to humanity and is the torch which illuminates the world." We certainly trust that your UniSA education has illuminated your world. You know, Pasteur's contribution to humanity was profound, and through his studies on pasteurisation, sterilisation and immunisation, that man arguably improved the quality of human life more than any other person. And it was his pioneering work in vaccination that gives us great confidence that humanity will prevail over COVID-19, just as it has prevailed against measles, polio, whooping cough, diphtheria, and so on. I wonder what such an accomplished mind, who did so much to enrich our world, would think of the superficial pseudoscience that finds its way into the minds of modern-day influencers. They know so little, but preach with such passion. Pasteur said that his success in so many fields of endeavour was due to his tenacity and his belief in careful, intense observation, a lifetime of commitment before he made his mark. It's these same qualities, coupled with desperation to solve a worldwide pandemic, that's allowed today's scientists to develop, test, and have approved a range of promising vaccines in record time. We are all bearing witness to phenomenal scientific work that defies what everyone had thought was possible. The fastest any vaccine had been previously developed prior to now was 4 years. This time it's been less than 12 months. I'm sure Pasteur would be very proud of how humanity has put his discoveries into such desperate practice. And so now it's your opportunity to make your impact on the world. Work hard to become the best professional you can, and above all, remain objective. And remember what Pasteur said about careful, intense observation and reflection. Use your knowledge and experience to make sound and timely professional judgments, and never ever stop learning, observing, questioning and reflecting. At UniSA, you've experienced a curriculum that is informed by our own research and the research of our global academic community. And I can't tell you how important it is that what we teach reflects what we research. We continue to refine our teaching and learning strategies, and just as we've hopefully inspired you, you, as students, have inspired us to do better through the way you've challenged us intellectually in the classroom and through the generous feedback that you've provided through the course of your studies. As Provost and Chief Academic Officer of this fine university, let me assure you that we take this feedback seriously. We learn from it, and we improve because of it. In closing, and on your behalf, I would like to thank our university community, our academic and professional staff, for their commitment to guiding you through your studies. This ceremony is for us a fitting tribute to the privilege we feel in having been part of your journey. There can be no better affirmation of that privilege than seeing you walk across this stage. It's a special moment for us, just as it is for you. So on behalf of UniSA, I wish you every success, every joy, and great fortune for the years to come. We're all extremely proud of you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor Evans. I now invite Professor Shane Dawson, Executive Dean, UniSA Education Futures, to begin the presentation of awards.
Chancellor, I present to you the candidates who have fulfilled the conditions for admissions of this awards of this university. I request that awards be conferred in absentia upon the other candidates whose names appear in the graduation ceremony handbook.
Professor Dawson, I have pleasure in conferring awards on all candidates who have complied with the prescribed requirements.
Chancellor, I present awards in UniSA Education Futures for the degree of Master of Education TESOL, Vibhuti Chadha. Ekta Chetri. Alice Jane Combe. Sanjita Hock. Yakun Hu. Pamela Karimi Kariuki. Charlene Liu. Anita Elsie Medlin. T. Thuy Yung Nguyen. Yishuan Yao. And Yan Yu. For the degree of Bachelor of Education, Early Childhood, Danielle Megan Allen. Tiana Renee Brook. Victoria Grace Fraser. Alison Louise Cannon. Caitlin Louise Kilford. Amy Octavia Kretschmer. Liang Yilin. Lisa Cecilia Joy Loeffler. Jessica Taylor Narcisi. Lisa Pulisi. Shirley Inda Satiti. Tracy Michelle Sterry. Alexandra Danielle Wilson. And Mia Rebecca Yudkin. For the degree of Bachelor of Education Primary, Rebecca Ashmore. Elma Sesko. Dempsey Jasmine Charlton. Cassandra Jane Cook. Emily May Cutts. Alessandra DeKira. Alicia Danielle Drummond. Amy Kathleen Fry. Rhiannon Gunter. Richard James Homersham. Georgia Brooke Klink. Rebecca Jade LaBella. Tegan Lee Love. Erin Lily March. Emma Grace Marcarioni. Mallory Jean McDowell. Tessa Chanel Michelin. Tyler Jade Millick. Brooke Zoe Moreland. Annie Claire Knoll. Claire Donna Papoulis. Stephanie Jane Patching. Taylor James Reinschmidt Ryan. Michaela Robinson Curley. Paige Rosie. Amy Lee Stott. Taylor Jane Tarker. Matthias Fotis Tsuru. Lana Vukadinovich. Georgia Lee Walden. And Brooke Taylor Webster. For the degree of Bachelor of Education, Primary and Middle, Brianna Lee Adams. Constantina Agalidis. Maggie Aris. Ivana Louise Barilo. Catherine Margaret Bennett. Anna Burris. Michaela Grace Carana. Anthony Cremona. Elise Marie Donato. Rebecca Louise Duell. Elisa Garcia Ferrara. Mackenzie Lee Fry. Kayleen Glizos. Stephanie Glizos. Shana Coral Green. Ashley Kate Henderson. Rebecca Kate Hillard. Stephanie Rochelle Hollins. Jamie Erin Inglis. Aaron Thomas Jelfs. Brittany Taylor Kosh. Bethany Joy Matern. Jean-Marie Nguyen. Michael Orphaner. Georgia Kate Parasiers. Eleni Pavlou. Ulysses Ramos. Brooke Shuey. Kayla Maria Sergi. Sakina Shafkat Ali. Holly Olivia Shaw. Brianna Lee Sharon. Ashujoyath Sidhu. Bridget Susan Jane Stapleton. Madeline Adele Stapley. Tamara Louise Starkey. Brooke Paige Strange. Rachel Emma Temby. Sarah Jane Williams. Hayley Woodward. And Claudia Jade Zerka. For the degree of Bachelor of Education, Secondary Design and Technology, Nicole May Bevan. And Sean Michael Davis. For the degree of Bachelor of Education, Secondary Food and Textiles Technology, Dana Raquel Bagshaw. Dana Raquel Bagshaw. Justine Claire Guest. And Tegan Lamont. Chancellor, this concludes the presentation of awards.
Thank you, Professor Dawson. Graduates, you have shared one of the most significant periods of your life with your colleagues at the University of South Australia. You have worked hard and earned a degree for one of the world's best young universities. Besides giving you the best academic start to your future careers, we want you to be productive members of society, and that is why we put so much emphasis on readying you for your future careers. Because of that, we have the best record among the state's universities for our graduate employment numbers. I know that in whatever your field of expertise, you will make a valuable and lasting contribution to your own communities and take part in a rapidly growing network of UniSA-inspired success stories who are all doing interesting and good work across the world. While on the subject of UniSA success stories, today we are assembled in the cultural and sporting heart of UniSA, Pridham Hall, where we celebrate all of our successes, including yours today. This building was made possible by a South Australian success story, a man named Andrew Pridham. Andrew is an alumnus of ours who, like you, graduated and went on to make his mark in the world, first in property management and then in merchant banking. Before he came back, to contribute to UniSA's vision for the future. Andrew donated $5 million towards this building, the largest single philanthropic donation UniSA has received to date. Andrew Pridham graduated from us with all of the attributes that you graduate today. You have the qualifications, coupled with a passion to do something positive you can make a real change to the world. And I do very much hope that you stay in touch with us and let us know what you're up to. You can do this through our alumni network, which now has almost 250,000 members. It is a network that is there to help you, to support you, and to give that connection to you back to your university. As you leave today, I wish you a world of opportunity and good fortune. But before you go, please stay seated while the rest of us in this assembly stand to congratulate you and wish you well on your journey.